A rapid descent this summer. The confidence crisis is real. His average second serve speed last year, when he had no issues whatsoever, 103 miles an hour. Montreal, it was 100. And it's just been dropping ever since. And in yesterday's match, it was really, really, really difficult to watch him struggle with this. I have so much admiration that he was able to still fight through in the groundstroke rallies and not let it completely deteriorate the rest of his game. But this is a major, major, major problem, and we hope he's able to solve it quickly.
I mean, it seems to be, to me, mental, because technically there's nothing wrong with his serve, but he actually hit one serve, second serve, that bottom of the net, and he did not mishit it. So he needs to fix that here, not here, but I think he'll be able to do it. But also yesterday, I think he ran out of gas. Those points were way too long. For a guy that's that tall and that lanky and that powerful, he needs to keep the points shorter, which means better finishes at the net. But that serve has got to be fixed first.
You guys know this better than I do, I'm sure. But when you see these double faults, you sense this miles per hour on the serve dropping, that's something the opponent on the other side of the net intuiting, using in strategy. I credit Diego Schwartzman with really a career win for him. That was just a great effort. But I think one of the problems with these double faults is that the player on the other side of the net knows it, and they knows what that encapsulates.
So, by the way, Schwartzman has been training at the Rafael Nadal Academy on Mallorca. Now he gets to try out against the boss. Let's go.